Music Access. Have you ever felt that people read others' minds? You're about to call someone and he or she calls you at the very same moment. You run into someone you really wanted to see in the same place at the right time. I think there's something called telepathy, and I hope that we can also communicate telepathically. I'm gonna send you my mental messages right now. Again, it means I am DJ Benji and are y'all with me? What's up, y'all? The first song y'all heard today, Tuesday, February 12th, 2019, was Talking About by Connor Maynard. What's up, y'all? It's your boy Music Access. This is DJ Benji in the studio. So that telepathy between friends, between homies, you know what the dealio is. Does that exist? That's not today's topic for the radio, but does it exist? I don't know. That is an excellent question I cannot answer fully. But what I can say is, there's definitely something that exists like that. You know, I've hit up my friend for the first time in a while, and then I'll hit him up and be like, yo, you know, I was just about to call you or something like that. And then, I don't know. I don't know if I can say that it really exists officially, but I can say that, you know, when you're really, really close with someone, or, you know, you got a lot of stuff to talk about with peoples, it is something that has a tendency to come up in conversation. So if you haven't hit up your close friends or your homies in a while, make sure to hit them up today. You know, it's not always about calling them. If you don't want to call them, just don't call them. Just send them a quick text. Just be like, yo, what's up? How you doing? And even if you're not able to do a complete text conversation right now, send it up. Let them know that you're thinking about them and, you know, you're willing to have a conversation at some point, and you should be fine. All right? Coolio. All right. So let's introduce our show and our program for today. In the first hour, we'll listen to famous pop songs from 1991 to 2010 from Monday to Friday on MA Chart Flashback. And we have MA Fun Fun Quiz and Message Time as well, so make sure to stay tuned. In our second hour, it's our Dating Advice Corner, as well as the time to talk about the difference between men and women. Men are from Mars, women are from Venus. Jane and Chi-Hun will be joining me in the studio in just a bit for the second hour. So stick around for that if you want some relationship advice. And for those of you who are sending in messages for our corner, remember to send it with details so we can help you out a little bit more. Of course, we do have our roll call in the middle of our first message time. To be part of that, all you have to do is send in a quick message just saying hi, asking a quick question, just tell me what's going on in your lives. Just remember to send it in, and we'll get to that in a bit. For listening to our program, you can listen through Arirang Jeju FM, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju-do Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo City, and 101.9 for the Daejeon area. You can also listen to us through a smartphone app and DMB, Ustream, TuneIn, etc. All you have to do is download the Arirang Radio app and you can use our services there. Letting y'all know the spelling of Arirang, it is A-R-I-R-A-N-G. Once again, A-R-I-R-A-N-G. And you can also listen to us through the satellite radio station Sirius XM channel 144 in the U.S. You can also listen to Music Access once again in the early morning. The rerun time is from 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. Korean time. So if you're unable to listen to us due to that time difference, try to check us out at the rerun time. Once again, that is 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. Korean time. Adjust accordingly. We're going to check out a track before we come back with our MA Chart Flashback. We're going to listen to the song Pots of Gold by Mama's Gun. Across time, across the universe, songs that take us back to the past. Let's listen to some heartwarming songs on MA Chart Flashback.
Visions of a musical plateau. Thoughts fill my mind, so I draw back and take aim. Lyrical shots blast.
We'll listen to famous pop songs from 1991 to 2010 from Monday to Friday on MA Chart Flashback. This month, we're playing hit pop songs from back in 2003. Here's today's song, let's take a listen. No need for breaks. And that's our track for our MA Chart Flashback today, Bring Me to Life by Evanescence. This is recorded for their debut studio album, Fallen, which was released in 2003. This was released as the lead single April 22nd of that year. It is a nu metal, goth metal, and rap rock song. It's got a lot of meanings and inspirations. Amy Lee, who is the vocalist of the band, revealed the song was inspired by her longtime friend and husband, Josh Hartzler. So I guess this also has something to do with a little bit of romance and how you are able to make me feel alive, kind of stuff like that. Critical response to the song was mostly positive, with critics praising the melody of the song, Lee's vocals, and the accompaniment by McCoy. It won in the category for Best Hard Rock Performance at the 46th Grammy Awards, where it was also nominated for Best Rock Song. And it did crazy good. Apparently the album itself, though, also did insanely well. Fallen is the debut studio for the debut album from the band. I found out Evanescence via, is it The Open Door? You never call me when you're sober. That's the first time I found out about the band. And that was 2006, but their debut album, Fallen, let's see, debuted at number 7 after selling 141,000 copies, but over worldwide it has sold to this date 17 million copies. That is insane. That is so many. And they had 5 nominations at the 46th Grammy Awards. Album of the Year, Best Rock Album, Best Rock Song, Best Hard Rock Performance, and Best New Artist. Yo, that's kind of crazy for a debut artist to have that many nominations in that wide of a category, especially Best New Artist along with Album of the Year. That's kind of insane, yo. Shout out to Evanescence for being able to pull through with something like this, and shout out to Amy Lee, who is currently the age of 37, and she's still performing in all of these amazing things. So, if you remember, guys, if you want to check out more music like this, this was the track Bring Me to Life by the band Evanescence from the album Fallen. But I think it's worth checking out their other music as well. They have a lot of great music in their discography, so make sure to go check it out. We're going to check out a song before we go into our message time. Unita of Indonesia requested No Place by the Backstreet Boys. We just heard the track No Place by the Backstreet Boys. Let's go to our roll call for today. We'll start with Darcy Ann of the USA, Crimson Rose of the USA, Makoto of Japan, Marwa of Morocco, Oksama of Japan, Ryoko of Japan, Yonit of Israel, Samantha of Australia, Tony of Italy, and Desiree of Korea. What's up, y'all, and welcome to the program. Hopefully y'all had a great lunch and you are energized for the day. Our message, Oksama of Japan saying, Hi, DJ Benji. 오늘 2월 12일에는 DJ Benji가 부활하고 100일이 되었어요. So it's been about 100 days since I came back as a DJ for radio. 매일 재미있는 방송을 감사해요. Thank you for always giving us fun broadcasts. 앞으로도 Benji 스타일로 멋진 토크와 음악을 기대할게요. I will look forward to more fun talks and more great music with DJ Benji. Yeah, it's kind of interesting to think that I've been back at radio for so long because I don't know if it was because the second time that I came back as a DJ and it wasn't the first time, readjusting or transitioning over to being a DJ again wasn't as hard at all. Actually, it was really, really natural. There wasn't any like problems with that or anything. When it came to just, you know, working in this environment, you know, it was so comfortable, you know, PD님, 작가님, all the guests were super, super tight. You know, it was amazing seeing Jane again and Shihyun again. Awesome meeting Heejun and Ben. And of course, you know, Tia, you know, I've known Tia for a while now. So it's just like, you know, I see her every week instead of just like once every 2 months or something. But it was really chill. It was very, very nice coming back. And 뭐 이렇게 라디오를 다시 돌아오게 돼서 진짜 너무 영광이고 너무 행복하고 너무 재밌고요. 앞으로도 좀 더 재밌는 시간을 많이 드릴 테니까 많이 기대해 주세요. 알겠죠? I'm gonna come back and we'll kind of try to make some more fun memories with this program. So stick around for that. It'll be super, 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 super awesome. All right, we're gonna check out a song before we go into our MA fun quiz. We're going to listen to She-Wolf by Shakira. Solving, answering, and enjoying questions with Benji on MA Fun Quiz. Yeah. At MA Fun Fun Quiz, we have a quiz. It could be about K-pop or Korean tradition, as well as trendy culture. MA Fun Fun Quiz is not difficult or complicated, and there's always three hints for the answer. The first hint will be a little hard, the second hint will be a little easier, and the third hint will be a music hint. So let's start today's MA Fun Fun Quiz. There's a lot of idol stars who use stage names, but then there are some who use their real names. Which of the following stars uses her birth name? First hint, one of these three is correct. Number one, Irene. Number two, Seoryeon. Number three, Chui. Second hint, she's a member of AOA. She really likes jjajangramyeon, black bean noodles. One noodle company heard this story, so she was chosen as the commercial model for the company. Really? I didn't know that. I guess when you get famous and you say you like something, you gotta get it. Alright, so do you guys know today's answer? If you know today's answer, go ahead and write answer on your title and send us a message with the correct answer. For those of you who don't know who it is yet, don't worry, we have a music hint that we'll get to after we check out a track. Maha of Norway, Maha, I don't know, of Norway's requested track, 행복했던 날들이었다, Days Gone by Day 6. We just heard the song, 행복했던 날들이었다, Days Gone by Day 6. Let's go back to our MA Fun Fun quiz. Before we get to our third music hint, here's our quiz and our first two hints. Today's quiz, which of the following stars uses her birth name? First hint, one of these three is correct. Number one, Irene. Number two, Seoryeon. Number three, Chui. Second hint, she's a member of AOA. She really likes jjajangramyeon or black bean noodles. One noodle company heard this story, so she was chosen as a commercial model for the company. Third hint is music hint, PD music cue. Yo, that sounds kind of like the old spicy detergent commercial. All right, so if you know today's answer, go ahead and write answer on your title and send us a message with the correct answer. We'll announce the answer to our quiz at the last part of our second hour corner. Men are from Mars, women are from Venus. Remember, send in your answer via send message or the comment function on the app. Let's check out some music. We're going to start with We Ally by Hajin, followed with Mia Japan's requested track, Orenmania, It's Been a While by Loco, featuring Zion T. We just heard the tracks We Ally by Hajin, followed with Orenmania, It's Been a While by Loco, featuring Zion T. Loco recently went to the army, and then he released his track before going, so hopefully we will be able to enjoy more of his great vocals on tracks he recorded before he went in, and some other great stuff as well. Time to go to our second message time. We're going to start us off with Papa Bay from the USA saying, hello, DJ Benji, how are you? Greetings from Seattle. We had lots and lots of snow in the past several days, and it's still snowing now. Walking outside in the snow reminded me of my memories of making a snowman with you. Also, the very special Christmas gift from you, a small picture frame with a picture of us and the snowman. Hope you have a wonderful day. Cheers! Yo, what's up, Dad? Alright, so we chilling in the studio. It's pretty cold in Korea now. It's not snowing. It hasn't snowed that much this winter at all. But we chilling. After radio ends, gotta go to musical practice. And but Seattle sounds fun. You know, lots of snowy weather in Seattle was super, super dope. We'd always make this snowman. And then in that little picture frame, I have my voice recorded, which at the time, it's funny because I actually had no idea what to get my dad. And I just like, I knew what to get my mom. I was like, all right, this seems like something like easy to do. And I recorded my voice in that. And that still exists to this day. Like that vocal file of me in 2000, I think it's 2004 or something. I don't know. But hopefully y'all are enjoying the winter out there. Remember, drive safely. If you're going to drive, don't drive if you can. And eat some nice, delicious food. Like canned soup sounds like a really good option. Some mushroom soup or some chicken noodle soup or tomato soup with some grilled cheese. That sounds delicious. I should be making that at home. All right, let's go to our next message. We got Yannit of Israel saying, hello, DJ Benji and MA fam. I missed you. How was your weekend? I'm walking out of my workplace. The place is closed and all of the workers are waiting. Oh, I'm waiting outside of my workplace. The place is closed and all the workers are waiting because someone forgot to wake up to open the workplace. Lol, have a great day. Does that happen? Does that happen? Yo, does that happen in real life? To like, you have to go to work and like no one opened the doors? I remember in college, we had this professor that would kind of show up late. So we'd all just be waiting outside the classroom. And if he didn't show up for like, I think it was like 15 minutes, then by the rules of college, that class was canceled for today and we could just leave. But I hope you got into your workplace fast enough, because I don't know. Let's see. What's the current temperature in Israel? Current temperature in Israel. It is 11 degrees Celsius. So it's not that warm either. So hopefully y'all are able to get in quickly. And remember, hopefully you have an amazing work day as well. Next, we got Florence of France saying, "Hello, Benji. Your intro made me think of the first time I met my best friend. Technically, we were classmates during high school, but barely talked at the time. Few years later, I found her on SNS and asked her if she wanted to get a drink with me. She said yes, and we spent an amazing night talking and laughing. Back home, I remember that I thought, I don't want this girl out of my life. And in the same time, she texted me saying, I know it sounds weird, but I don't want you out of my life. And she is my best friend since." Oh, that's a nice story. That's really, really good. You know, it's true that once you get out of, college or high school, high school seems like your entire world. Everything, every single experience seems like, if your high school experience sucks, then your whole life is going to suck. But it has nothing to do with that, because high school is just a current point in your life. But then again, it's also good to catch up if you have the opportunity to. And it's great because these days, through the power of SNS, it is so easy to just, add someone. Especially, I don't know how many people still use FB, because I ain't using that no more because I had to get rid of it when I was a trainee. But for the people that do use that, I don't know if sending, friend requests and all that stuff is still, as much of a thing as it was then. I remember the max amount of friends you could have is, I think it was 5,000 at the time, before it turns into a page and not like a personal account. But I kept adding people and adding people and adding people. I had a lot of people on my account, and then now I guess I don't. But y'all, FB, IG, hit them up through the DMs. Slide into the DMs. But if they're like a friend, and then it's not really sliding into the DMs. You're just kind of, I guess, waltzing in. I guess that might be the more appropriate term. But yes, definitely keep up with some old friends, and you may have experience like Florence. All right, we also have Ryoko of Japan saying, "Hi, Benji. Did you see the results of the Grammy Awards? Record of the year, not album of the year, but record of the year went to Childish Gambino for This Is America. I didn't know that the music video director was a Japanese person. I was very surprised to know that, and I'm glad. The music video seems to be, it's like watching a movie. It's a really amazing video. We hope B.I.G. can become a Grammy Awards singer." Thank you. Yeah, hopefully we can. I want to go to the Grammys as a boy. BTS was at the Grammys presenting the best R&B album, which went to her. Yo, shout out to her. We don't play enough her on the radio. For those of you who may not know who her is, I'm not saying stuff grammatically incorrect. Her name is Gabriella Wilson, better known as her stage name, H.E.R, pronounced her. It's an acronym for Having Everything Revealed. She was in Disney's Next Big Thing, I guess, in 2009. She started coming out with the current, her artist persona in 2016. And then she was nominated for 5 Grammys this year, winning 2 for Best R&B Performance and Best R&B Album. Best R&B Performance was Get You by her and Daniel Caesar, I believe. So, y'all, make sure to go check it out. Oh, Best Part, not Get You. Get You is just Daniel Caesar. So make sure to check it out if you haven't checked it out. Other Grammy nominations, or who won a Grammy for best album this year? Who was that? Best R&B album was her. Best country album was Casey Musgraves. Oh yeah, I think that was album of the year, Casey Musgraves. That's right. Record of the year, This Is America, Childish Gambino. Song of the year, This Is America. Best new artist was Dua Lipa, which makes sense. Yo, I mess with Dua Lipa. And finally, my personal favorite, best rap album was Invasion of Privacy by Cardi B. Unfortunately, it didn't go to Mac Miller, but we'll get a little bit of that later. For now, let's check out 2 more tracks. We're going to start with Always Remember Us This Way by Lady Gaga, followed with Mystery of Love by Sufjan Stevens. We just heard the tracks Always Remember Us This Way by Lady Gaga, followed with Mystery of Love by Sufjan Stevens. So this does bring our first hour to a close. Before we close it off completely, first we're going to do a Jeju-do Island weather report. The current weather on Jeju-do Island is 7 degrees Celsius. There is a cold breeze blowing through the island, so please, if you're going to go outside of the house, don't forget to dress warmly. In the afternoon and through dinner, or I guess the evening is the better term, there is going to be a little bit of fine dust in the air. So if you are planning to go outside, make sure to wear a mask. For now, of course, in our second hour, we'll come back with Jane and Shihyun for Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus. We'll be talking about various stories from our MA fam related to love, relationships, and the difference between dudes and dudettes, so make sure to stay tuned. To wrap things up for our first hour, I'm gonna let y'all hear the track that Kimmy of the USA requested, Silence by Marshmello featuring Khalid, and I will be right back. Music Access. What's up, y'all? The second hour for Music Access has begun. What's up? It's your boy DJ Benji. In the second hour, Jane and Shihyun will be joining me for Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus in just a bit. Before that, here's how you can listen and participate. If you use a computer, just visit www.arirangradio.com and you can listen and watch the program that's on air live. All you have to do is click on the banner that says Music Access, and that will take you to our homepage where you can leave your messages, song requests, and participate on our weekly corners via Send Message. You can also listen through Arirang Jeju FM, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju-do Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo City, and 101.9 for the Taejong area. You can also listen to us through a smartphone app and DMBU, Stream TuneIn, etc. All you have to do is download the Arirang Radio app and you can use our services there. You can also check us out through the satellite radio station, Sirius XM Channel 144, only in the US. And after checking out a track, we'll be back with Jane and Shihyun for MMWV. We're going to hear No by CLC. Men and women, women and men.
How are we different?
How are we the same?
Let's find out through Men Are From Mars,
Women Are From Venus.
Hello, Jane and Shihyun.
Hello.
What's up?
Well, I'm enjoying my coffee right now.
Mm-hmm.
Courtesy of Jane.
Mm-hmm.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Jane.
Mm-hmm. Thank you,
Why am I
Hardy?
Drinking this coffee?
Because... Oh man, you just really want to rub it in my face.
You gotta tell them. I can't just say I'm drinking coffee courtesy of Jane.
So, we did a bet on the Super Bowl, and I was all in for the Rams, and Benji was rooting for the Patriots. So, yeah, the Patriots
won.
They won.
It was such a bad score, though. 3-13, really?
Yeah.
Really? Mm-hmm. In the Super Bowl? Really? Anyways. All right, and Shihyun, you are looking mighty tanned. Mighty tanned.
Mm-hmm, I'm looking a little bit tanned, I guess.
Not as much in the camera, though.
Yeah, not as much. I mean, watching myself in the camera, I actually look quite, you know, like average
Yo,
skin color.
I look the palest out of all of us right now on
camera. You look very pale. You look sick, actually.
Is it because of the mask?
It's like all of a sudden I am sick. No, but it's all in jest. But for real though, you look great. You know, I guess you've been having a lot of... I saw on the IG.
Uh-huh.
Lots of the underwater adventures.
Uh-huh.
Lots of the bikini pics.
Yes, I'm going up the ladder on the, you know, the diver scale.
Level 3 or something?
Level 4.
Level 4.
Yeah, level 4 free diving. And then rescue diver for the scuba.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. So going up the scale. Mm-hmm.
You see the confidence going up the scale. Mm-hmm.
I'll be up there one day.
So later when we all go to Sydney for a vacation, you can pull us out of the water, right?
Pretty much, but I don't know. I have to decide. That's the thing about rescue divers. I can decide whether to rescue you or not. So yeah.
Angie, you gotta be nice to her.
Exactly,
wow,
my point.
Really? Wow, that was cold. That was cold. That was cold. All right, so comedian Bang Nara's ex-boyfriend looked upon everything with suspicious eyes. I don't know what that means. Bang Nara's toilet flush sound was quite weird, so her ex always asked her to do this. If you're home now, go to the bathroom and flush the toilet.
Mm-hmm. Her boyfriend was checking up on her. So whether she was home, whether she was outside with somebody else. So like, go to the bathroom and flush your toilet.
To prove that you're home?
Uh-huh.
She could just go to any toilets.
But no, that's why her different. Toilet sounded different.
Yeah.
How would you know?
How would you know?
You know if
with
you've been
mics
there.
These days? I mean, like, if you have a boyfriend or girlfriend, don't you FaceTime them these days?
Yeah.
You just use video calls. Just be like, yeah, where are you? What you doing? And it's not like I'm checking up on you. Just that's the way we communicate.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, if you're in a relationship where that becomes a problem, then...
Exactly.
You got stuff to work out, yo.
Mm-hmm. If you have to lie about it.
If you have to lie about it. Mm-hmm. But have you ever, you know, met a guy or met a boyfriend who's always super skeptical? As in, like, super, like, sus?
My very first boyfriend was very skeptical, very suspicious of everything I did. And I think that, in a way, kind of shaped the person I am now, in a way, because afterwards, if the guy didn't act, not as much as him, of course, but at least a little suspicious, I get worried as though,
really?
Like, is he, yeah, into me? Does he like me? It does shape a person.
I do understand that.
Wait, do you agree or disagree?
I do understand that in a way, but... I'm only saying this because, you know, you do want to get that attention from
exactly.
your partner. You do want your partner
of course.
To, you know, just be worried mm-hmm. in some point. But at the same time, it's because I don't like to be questioned a lot.
For sure.
That's why I'm like, I do kind of get it. So
you want the attention, but you don't want the suspicion.
Yeah.
So you want them to want to know where you are, mm-hmm. but you don't want them to be like, oh, what you doing? Oh, I'm with my friends. Okay, that's good. But it's like, what are you doing? I'm with my friends. Where are you at? Oh, I'm at this pizza place.
Who are you with? What are you eating?
There was one point when he actually came to the cafe to see if I was there.
That's scary.
That's weird. Yeah. That's mm-hmm. really sketchy. Yo, I don't know. I can't deal with that. No, I don't think I've ever had a girlfriend that was like that, though.
I think there's a difference between, you know, when you're asking all these questions because you're really curious. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when you're asking this to check up on that person.
Right.
You can tell, though.
Yeah, you could tell.
You can tell.
You can tell the difference between caring and suffocating.
Yeah.
Yeah. But there's also a fine line. Because for some people, they might want suffocating.
Maybe.
They want people to be like, what are you doing? Oh, he wants to know where I am, or she wants to know where I am.
Like, they like that.
They like the fact that there's so much spotlight and attention. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a fine line. It depends on your personality, though.
Yeah.
That's why you got to date people, guys. You have to date around. Like, not, like, a lot. I'm not saying date a lot, but you need to know what your type is. Like, mm-hmm. the type of person that you chemically react well with, mm-hmm. so to speak. You know what I'm saying?
But toilet flushing.
Yo, maybe her toilet makes noise when she flushes.
That's on
it.
A different level.
That's on another level.
Yeah.
All right, so what about y'all? When you are in a relationship, do you look upon everything with suspicious eyes?
I think that is very unhealthy.
Do you do it, though?
No.
A little bit?
No.
Never?
I think it's weird not to at the same point.
Well,
like, suspicious as in what sense?
As in, not like, I want to know where you are and what you're doing, but I want to know where you are, what you're doing, who you're with, what time you're going to be doing that till... You know, but that's being suspicious. And then just having interest is, you know, what are you doing? Oh, cool. Where you at?
Again, very fine line because, because you might be thinking not, oh, okay, is this person doing, you know, something suspicious with someone else? But it could be more like, okay, I want to know what time you finish so that I can make my plans.
Yeah.
Which is very important for girls.
Really?
Yeah. Like turning up at a place that you're supposed to meet way early so you don't give the girl time to get dressed, you know, put makeup on, things like that.
Random question. Well, I have two questions. The first question is, so then if you have plans to meet a girl, is it better to show up later or just be on time? Time is the more...
I'd say on time or maybe like 10 minutes early, but never earlier than that.
Okay. And don't be late, though.
Oh,
even if the girl takes longer, you be on time.
Yeah, you
mm-hmm.
wait.
Mm-hmm.
You wait for the girl.
That's so
rude. I mean, I wouldn't mind waiting. I wouldn't mind waiting, but if it happens all the time, then it will annoy me.
But what if he comes late, but you're always late too? Then it doesn't matter, right?
As long as you're there before her, yeah. I mean, it doesn't matter.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, yeah.
Mm. Right. Don't try to play me on this. Don't be like, ladies be don't. I know ladies be taking their time. I was supposed to meet this one friend to go, like, do something. I don't remember what it was.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, all right, so we'll meet at 6. And I was like, yo, I'm just going to be chilling at home because I just need, like, 되게 친하니까. It was like someone mm-hmm. I was really, like, close with. So literally, I'm just going to, like, not wash
mm-hmm.
and come out in, like, sweats and stuff.
Ew.
So it's going to take me 5 minutes. So you just let me know when you're going to do, you're done with your stuff. We were supposed to meet at 6.
Yeah.
She hits me about like 7:30. She's
oh,
like,
that's
yo,
bad.
I'm ready to go. I was like, are you kidding? Are you playing? I'm not leaving my house now. I'm eating at home. I'm getting some... Oh, I almost said the brand. I'm getting some golden arches. All right. So anyways, that is our, I guess, our descriptions of men and women for suspicions and all that stuff. So, of course, we got to do our psychological evaluation
mm-hmm.
test. What is today's test?
So today's test will tell you how you act when you're away from your partner.
So do listen to the question and the four choices I'm going to give to you right now. Do get your hands busy. Do leave your messages on the Arirang Radio send message or the Arirang Radio application by clicking on the comment button.
Yeah.
So here is the question. There are four doors in front of you. Your partner opened the door and walked towards you. Which door did the partner open? Number one, an iron door. Number two, a wood door. Number three, a glass door. Number four, a door with electronic device.
It's like an automatic door.
Yeah, an automatic door.
Like electrocuting door?
I don't know. You never know. You might have like a pin button or something. I don't know. An electronic device door.
I feel you.
Mm-hmm. So iron, wood, glass, or the automatic electronic door.
All right, so we'll let y'all know what each door means, but go ahead, listeners, and let us know which door did your partner walk through. What is your choices? Leave us messages on our send message on our website or via the comment function on the app. So, first of all, we gotta decide first.
Mm-hmm.
So, ladies and ladies.
I'm just gonna pick the thing that just popped up my head, which is number four.
Really?
Number four?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
It's interesting. I thought that'd be the last one to go through.
No, because I'm just imagining my partner meeting me up like somewhere outside.
Oh. Oh, like a cafe.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. So you're already thinking about the dates, huh?
Yeah, no. What do you pick?
No, I always pick last because I'm the DJ. I have to build suspense up. And also, I have no idea. So, wait, what did you pick?
Wood door.
I actually was going to pick wood door just because it seems like that's the most normal kind of just door.
Exactly. The average door.
Yeah, the average door. But then...
Are you calling me weird?
I didn't say that. You said that. Don't put words in my mouth, Shane. You're so weird. All right, I'm going to pick then, just because Game of Thrones is coming back this year.
Oh.
Yeah, they are having, you know, they're doing the last season this year.
It's the last season.
That's still on?
Yeah, it is.
You've never watched it, have you?
No.
Exactly. For those of you who don't watch it, they have the same reaction as Jane. Mm-hmm. And for those people who do watch it, mm-hmm. they're totally excited.
Oh, kind of way. In a way, I guess. Because I've been watching it and then I kind of, didn't, because it's just so much of a wait, you know, just waiting around to see the next season.
But it is fun, right? I heard it's super fun.
It is fun when you get to know everything and you know what's going on, but in the beginning you're like, oh my gosh, this is so confusing because there's just so many houses, so many places, areas, different names.
Hodor. Hodor.
Except for maybe him.
Oh no! Spoiler, Jane doesn't even know what that is.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so you picked wood door, Jane picked a door with an electronic device, and I will pick an iron door. Just because, mm-hmm. Iron throne. Mm-hmm. Although I have a feeling iron door is not a good thing.
Who knows?
Who knows? That is true. Alright, so of course we gotta check out a track before we come and reveal what each choice means. Jane.
What up?
What did you pick for your songs?
Alright, so I picked this song because of a specific artist who was also nominated for one of the Grammy Awards.
Okay.
It is called Say My Name by David Guetta, Bebe Rexha, and J Balvin.
Yeah! We just heard the track Say My Name by David Guetta and Bebe Rexha and J Balvin. Who was the one that was nominated?
Bebe Rexha.
Ooh.
So, well, I don't really follow her, I never did, but I came across this interview. Actually, no, going way back on her IG, and she posted this video of herself basically, talking about the fact that designers refuse to design her to make a dress for her.
Okay.
For the awards, and it was because of her size.
Oh.
What's with her size?
I'm gonna go look it up.
Basically, they were saying she's too big.
Okay. Oh.
And you know, this is like hurtful, but it didn't kill her vibe. She looked amazing in the Grammy Awards,
mm-hmm.
in that beautiful red dress, and
I don't get it.
She doesn't look big at all.
Exactly, that's the thing. So she's like, you know what? This isn't my problem. This is yours. I'm gonna live my life, be happy, and she was just bringing all good vibes in the awards. So I like this artist.
I'm looking at her. That sounds weird if I say it like that. I'm looking at like what she looked
photos.
Like in the dress.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she looks good.
Yeah.
I like the dress.
And I don't remember who won. Was it Dua Lipa?
For New Artist?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was Dua Lipa. I thought her might win.
Yeah, but yeah, regardless of who won, like she BB Rexa, she was still in good vibes. She partied with all her crew, her staff, her family, and yeah, mm-hmm. I just really like that about her.
Still a nominee. Yeah, that's a huge thing.
That's not the important, but the important thing is Drake won for best rap track, mm-hmm. and then he totally shaded the Grammys. Oh. He's like, if you're an artist and you got people singing your song word for word, you mm-hmm. got your hometown hero, this holds no relevance to you.
Ooh.
This is just something. This is not like actual sports where you get an MVP because you won a game or mm-hmm. you achieved something. This is just, you know, some people who help vote for this might not even know anything about music.
Yeah.
And he shaded the Grammys and they cut him off mid-speech.
Mm.
I think there were a lot of things going on during the Grammy Awards.
The Ariana Grande
behind
thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was interesting.
Yeah. Anyway, let's go back to our, what do we do on our corner? We talk about romance or something, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Cool. You're listening to our Tuesday Corner with Jane and Sheehan. Men are from Mars. Women are from Venus. We just did a psychological test to find out how we act when we're away from our partners. So it is time to find out the results.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So the question was, your partner is coming through a door. Which door did this partner come through? And the first choice was the iron door.
Oh my goodness.
Mm-hmm. Benji chose this one. It means you were never the sweet, friendly type to your partner. You have no problem spending time without your significant other, and you can end up feeling there is no need to keep seeing each other.
That's true.
So you think that you'd rather meet someone else than having to stay away from your boyfriend or girlfriend for a long time.
I didn't get the last part.
Yeah, me too.
But mm-hmm. It applies. It's happened.
Mm-hmm.
It's happened. That's happened. I don't want to say I fully agree with this, but there are actually a lot of points that I can kind of agree with.
Right.
Yeah, just because, like, if you meet someone for a long time, mm-hmm. you know, I'm not looking to get married next week.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if there's going to be problems that are interfering with, like, my work
mm-hmm.
or something like that, or, like, I need to go hang out with people,
mm-hmm.
but then I don't want to have to be like, oh, you know, I'm going to go out with these people, you know, and it's like, why? Who are you going to meet? When are you going to be back? What are you going to be doing? And I'm just like, I mean, you know, I get those moments sometimes.
Couldn't that actually mean you don't like this person that much?
That's possible too. Okay. It depends.
Mm.
You know, you can't just say I'm this based on that.
Mm-hmm.
But there are points that when I start losing interest in a person, this definitely occurs. I will say that.
Yeah.
I do say that.
I would think if I put somebody before anything else, mm-hmm. that's the person I'm supposed to marry. You
yep.
know? Mm-hmm.
That makes mm-hmm. sense.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right, moving right on. The wood door. A lot of people chose this one. I chose this one. Darcy Ann from USA chose this. Yunita from Indonesia. Samantha from Australia. Makoto from Japan chose Ooh. This one as well. Although you are away from your partner now, you're happy just thinking that you'll meet your love again in the future. Even though you're not with your partner, you believe in him or her, and you never suspect him or her of doing anything fishy. You do not complain either. But this kind of attitude could make your partner feel you are indifferent to him or her.
True that.
Mm-hmm.
Makes sense.
Do you agree?
I kind of do. If he has to go away for some reason, I kind of just understand and just live with it.
It's like, okay.
Hmm.
Let me know when you're back.
Exactly.
When you come back, bring some, like, McD's or something.
Hmm. But the thing is, like, I don't not worry about this person, but I guess I don't show it as much.
Because you trust the person.
Yeah.
And, you know, nothing's going to happen anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Because you come back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard a butt somewhere.
Yeah, I did. But I guess from the other person's point of view, yeah, that person might feel, you know, I'm being indifferent to them.
That's true. Mm-hmm. That makes sense. All right. So what's the next one again?
Next one was the glass door.
Oh, no.
Tony from Italy chose this one. You don't want to be away from your partner even for a little while. You have the jitters just thinking about your love being away, and you'd rather accompany your partner wherever he or she goes and not live away from him or her. So you're the one who always visits your partner wherever he or she is.
Yo, I get the iron, wood, glass. It's going down. Do you feel that? The iron's like, you don't really care
mm-hmm.
at all.
Mm-hmm.
And then the wood's like, you do care,
mm-hmm.
but it can come off as not caring.
Mm.
And then glass, you can just totally
Very
see through. It's fragile.
Yeah.
So what happens with the electronic door?
Theoretical. What do you think will happen?
Oh,
I'm
no.
I'm going to give you a choice.
I think the electronic door is like,
be
maybe,
careful with your words.
I don't speak English that well, so you're just going to have to read it. I don't know.
All right, let's move on.
Got this fist ready.
Yeah,
be careful
Jane's ready.
With your words.
Oh, really? You want to buy another coffee?
All right, moving on. The last one was the door with the electronic device or the automatic door. You make an objective observation even though you're away from your partner. Although you miss your significant other and you want to meet him or her, you try to endure it and keep to your life's pace. You tend to overcome difficulties, but when you lose interest in your partner, you cheat on him or her and are likely to end the relationship.
Wait, I get the second part, but I don't get the first part.
You make an objective observation when you're away from your partner.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then, although you miss this person, you endure it and you keep to your life's pace. And then you find, you know, what is good for you. You know, do you keep your interest in this person or do you find someone else?
I mean, I kind of agree. But, I mean, I wouldn't cheat on them. I'd just break up with them and just meet someone new.
Oh,
that's simple.
Easy. 1 + 1 = 2.
Yeah.
2 - 1 = 1.
Yeah.
I feel you. All right. So hopefully y'all enjoyed our psychological evaluation. I am indifferent. Jane is like straight to the point.
Smart.
And Shihan is a very loving person.
Aww.
All right. So now it is time to get into our messages from our listeners. Jane, can you read our message for us?
Sure. So this message is from Hee Jong from Australia.
Hello.
Tuesday Corner, my best one. Shihan, Jane, and of course, Benji. Hello. I am dating a Korean man and he lived in Australia for 10 years. More than 10 years. But he wants to get married. Not in Australia though. He wants to get married in Korea and live in Korea. What should I do? I am working in Australia now, but I love him.
Wow. Okay. So he jumped from Australia, sent us a message. What do you think about this message? If you're living abroad and your boyfriend or girlfriend wants to get married in their hometown and live there, what will you do? Go ahead and let us know your opinions via send message or the comment function on the app. We'll get to those messages in just a bit. I don't know.
I think this is very different from all the messages that we got before.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is... It puts me in a place where I have to be careful with what I say.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
I can't really say much and say, yeah, this is right. Like, what I'm saying is, like, the best advice.
Why do I use a Korean? No, but I feel like that's kind of the point of this program. We're not here to say this is the answer, but this is our 2 cents. You know,
collectively. But at the same time, I'm not married. I'm not, like, on the point on getting married anytime soon.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm engaged.
So, I mean, no, I'm just curious to what Shihan only might say.
True.
If this was, you know, if you were in this situation, because obviously you're married and...
So I'm guessing Hee Jung's Australian, like she's lived there her whole life. Because from her ID, I'm thinking, isn't she Korean too? But anyway, if you have to really decide on where you want to live, I guess it's a huge decision because in a way you can, I guess, break up your relationship with this person.
I mean, yes.
Yeah.
Can you stop?
What is this?
Brain is fried right now, bro. Alright, so I actually have some 2 cents to put in as well. But first, we gotta listen to Shihan's song request for today.
Mm-hmm.
What song did you pick? I really like this song.
Oh, you do? Great.
What is it?
Well, I like this song too. So I chose this one by Zed and Alicia Cara. It's called Stay.
Woo!
Ooh.
We just heard the track Stay by Zed and Alicia Cara. And we have Hee Jong from Australia sending us a message. Today we're talking about this issue. If you're living abroad and your boyfriend or girlfriend that you're currently in a relationship with wants to get married in their hometown and live there, what will you do? So Shihan was mentioning about how, you know, it really kind of depends on a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted to add in my thing. I think part of it also depends on how long y'all have been like dating. So for example, if y'all have been dating for like less than a year, like it doesn't matter whether, you know, y'all are 20 or whether y'all are 30. Of course it is different because theoretically speaking, if you're in your 30s, you have dating experience from your 20s that in your 30s you can kind of utilize to think about whether this is a good decision or not, or this is an emotional decision. But then I feel like if you've been dating for a few years, this is something that you should have a serious talk about. This isn't something to just like be like, oh, I don't know, I'm not sure. It's like literally I am uprooting my life for you, and you have to take responsibility,
right?
You know, if I can't find work there, you have to provide for everything.
Exactly.
And if I do find work, it's going to be totally different from now. I don't know how good your Korean is, but let's say this dude, you know, he's Korean or whatever, and he comes back to Korea, you have to learn Korean. That's a whole other thing. You know, it's something that, you know, it's not moving from, you know, Perth to Sydney. Yeah. It's not moving from, you know, London to Manchester. Are those the same place?
No, they're not the same places.
I'm just checking. It's, you know, it's moving totally different. Like, let's say, Jane, let's say you and me were dating for like a year. And then all of a sudden I'm like, yo, you know what? I'm in love with you. I want to get married. Let's go to my hometown of Germany.
I think, I mean, I would understand where the guy's coming from, but at the same time, I would be kind of lost / angry.
Because, like, your opinion was not really taken into account, quote-unquote?
Yeah, I think, because from a girl's perspective, like you said, there's a lot of sacrifice that needs, that's ended up being made. So, I think, at the same time, I wouldn't really want to leave my hometown.
Because it's a big decision.
Yeah.
I think that's the thing. You have to decide what you want. You have to know what you want, and you have to tell him what you want. And then try to work something out from there. Because actually, my sister went through exactly the same thing. She met her husband in Australia. So they got married there. But he never actually mentioned to her that he wanted to come back to Korea and work here. But that was only after they got married. They had a first kid. So it kind of just happened out of the blue. And she actually went to Australia in maybe like her last year of high school. So not that quick, not that early. So for her, moving then at that time was like for her life. It was for her final decision to live there forever. But then because she met this guy who wanted to go back to Korea, it was a kind of a, you know, a very big decision. I guess in a way she had no choice but to follow him back because she wasn't working at the time. She was a full-time mom. But she still hates living in Korea. She likes Australia. She likes the weather there. She likes the climate there. And she always had like allergy problems in Korea. And she never had that in Australia. So that was a big thing. And still now she wants to go back. So this isn't some decision that just kind of, you know, is like a one-off decision and it'll be there forever. Like my sister still, I mean, her kid is now in middle school and she's still thinking of going back to Australia. So it's always going to be there if you want to go back. So you really have to be really clear on what you want and talk to him about it. And maybe you guys can come up with a plan, maybe like first 5 years in Korea, see how what happens. And if it doesn't work, go back to Australia, something like that.
I agree with both of you. Just one more thing I want to add on top of that, though, is if you are making this decision, one, remember, this is our decision, not his and not yours, singularly. If you're planning on getting married, the minute that marriage thing comes in, of course, you are living separate lives, but decisions like this, you have to come to the middle. And it should never be, I'll go with it for now. Ever. And plan it out. It's not, okay, so we'll go next year and we'll have our moving stuff. When I get there, where am I going to work? What am I going to be doing? You know, it's even worse when you have nothing to do. It's even worse because you're just at home and, you know, you don't have anything to do. Even if you say you're like doing housework or whatever, that's, there's not a lot of stuff to do, surprisingly, in comparison to what you might have been doing, you know, in your original area. You know what I'm saying?
And for Heejung, I'm thinking her family, her friends, everybody is living in Australia. So she's leaving everything behind for something that she doesn't know what she'll get. Because she's not the one who's looking for work in Korea.
I think it won't be like a bad thing to move to Korea because you can always go back.
Can you? About the money that's involved.
So let's say the guy saying, I want to go to Korea. Maybe he's got a really good job offer, right? So they come here. But then in the end, because personally, if I have kids, I don't want to raise them in Korea. And I'm pretty sure a lot of parents think that.
But so, that's a huge dilemma, though.
That's the thing. Like, I mean, I don't know if that is. I mean, I'm not going to say everyone would think that, but I know a lot of people who prefer their kids to have their educational background, like all that experience outside of Korea. And if they do have an opportunity, like that's another way to, another reason to, you know, just go back to Australia. So I think in a way I understand what she's going through and like, you know, just it being stressful to her because she's like sacrificing a lot. But at the same time, being able to go to Korea and Australia, having that opportunity, I think, you know, you really need to just think about this. Sit down with your boyfriend,
Yes.
Yeah, boyfriend, fiance, and, you know, just talk about it and don't talk as in like, oh, this is going to be our rest of our, like, the rest of our lives is going to be in Korea.
But I just wanted to add, like, if you're relocating once and you have a job for like 5 years or so, relocating another time, it's difficult.
It's hard.
It is hard, but I know it's also it's a possible thing.
It's not, yeah, it's not totally closed off. Yeah. But it can be difficult. Like, let's say, okay, I gotta wrap this up quick, but if I'm doing like K-pop here, then all of a sudden I want to do a singer in like somewhere else randomly, I still have the basic skill set, but I have to set it up all over again. And exactly. Once I've sort of set it up there to go somewhere else again, would be really hard.
You're doing it twice.
I feel like, maybe. Anyways, Heejung, hopefully our advice was able to help you out. Remember, if you have any other continuing questions or concerns, go ahead and send it in to us. You can send in your, and this goes for everybody, you can send us all your concerns on our love and dating via our send message. Just write MMWV on your title and send it in via send message or the comment function on the app. So send us a lot of messages, and it is time to wrap up for today. Y'all have fun?
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
Have everyone listening did.
All right, we're going to check out the track Come Back to Earth by Mac Miller, and I'll see y'all next week. Bye.
Bye.
We just heard the track Come Back to Earth by Mac Miller. Time to reveal the answer for MA Fun Fun Quiz. The answer is Seolhyun. Seolhyun is a celebrity who uses her birth name. Her real name is Kim Seolhyun. Congratulations to Leontio of Singapore, Yunita of Indonesia, Yanit of Israel, Makoto of Japan, Chungte of Korea on getting the answer right. And hopefully y'all are able to participate in tomorrow's quiz as well. We're going to check out two more tracks as we continue along. Leontio of Singapore's requested Want by Taemin, and Makoto of Japan requested Pinnari Shine by Pentagon. And this does bring our show for a close. For today, our last song is There Will Be by Sam Ok. And to my MA fam, have a lovely day.